have a chance to the tree of life. We have a race to run. Church, we have a race to run. Don't get tired and don't give up. Build up the arms and put up the feeble knees and keep on running the race. Trouble is going to come, but keep on running the race. Trials and tribulations is going to come, but keep on running the race. For Jesus has gave us his example for running the race. For we are his joy that he kept on pressing toward on his track. So don't give up when trouble comes, when bills seem to cloud you. Don't give up when your wife seems to don't understand. Don't give up when your brothers seem to don't understand. Keep on running to Jesus Christ, the author and finisher of our faith. Don't give up when your past life seems to shame you. Keep on running to Jesus Christ. Don't give up when they talk about you. Keep on running to Jesus Christ. Don't give up when the bills be overdue. Keep on running to Jesus Christ. Don't give up when your children don't want to do right. Keep on running to Jesus Christ. Don't give up when the world just seems to press you down. Keep on running to Jesus Christ. Keep your head up and keep your knees pumping. Keep on running to Jesus Christ. Let the Lord heal you from all of your sins. Keep on running to Jesus Christ. Jesus is waiting for you and I to come to him, for he is the example that we need to keep on running this race. Lay aside every weight. Lay aside every sin that seems to keep us pressed down. We have a race to run. The race is not given to the swift, but to those who endure. We have to run this race with patience. And under all that, patience is love. We have to run this race with joy, with peace, with discipline, that others may see us and glorify our Father, which is in heaven. So consider Jesus. Consider what he went through. For the word says that ye have not yet resisted into blood, striving against sin. Talking about us. We haven't resisted temptations into blood. Nobody but Jesus. Nobody but Jesus has resisted unto blood. For he shed his blood on that old rugged cross that you and I might have a chance to the tree of life. We don't have what it takes to resist unto blood. Nobody but Jesus shed his precious blood for you and I. He endured the shame, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand on the throne of God, interceding for you and I. And even those who pierced him in his side is going to have to answer. Even those who hung him on the cross are going to have to answer. But for you and I, we have to answer also. But one day, we're going to be with him in eternity. And he's going to say, well done. You endured the shame. You braved the trail. You looked at me as an example. When they treated you bad, you stood fast. When they talked about you, you continued to run. When they slapped you, you turned the other cheek. When they hated you, you loved them. You kept on running, my good and faithful servant. When they gave up on you, you stood firm. When they lied on you, you prayed for them. You fed the hungry. You told the world about me. You blazed the trail. You lifted me up and not man. You blazed the trail. Thank God for Jesus. So hold on. And you're going to see that running the race was well worth it. Because the trouble that we face down here can't compare to the glory that we're going to receive in heaven. And I thank God for his son, Jesus Christ, who blazed the trail for you and I. And I also thank God for those old patriarchs who stood firm, being bought and all, so their children being taken away, destitute and tormented. But even with that, they still can't compare to Jesus Christ, the author and the finisher of our faith. So whether you run the race or not, Jesus still is the author and finisher of your faith. And he's going to either judge you or tell us to come on home and have a little rest. So it's up to you and I what kind of race we ran. Did we run the race that the Lord set before us? Or do we run the other race that the devil set before us? But either way, we got a race to run, church. And our race is in Christ Jesus. And he is our foundation. That if we stick to him and look for him, the author and finisher of our faith, we'll make it and we'll be all right. We'll be all right. So don't worry, church. Everything is going to be all right if you run the race that the Lord has set before you. He knows it's going to be trouble. He knew you was going to have doubt. He knew I was going to step back sometime. He knew I was going to step to the right and get out of track sometime. But thank God for his grace that it brings me back on track. And I can put my eyes back on Christ and put my track shoes back on and lift them up and stretch out and take my medicine, take my aspirin, and keep on running in Jesus Christ, because I know he got his hands held out telling me to come on and keep on running, because everything is going to be all right. Even when I'm sick, I know he's going to make a way. All I got to do is keep on running. When they talk about me, just keep on running. When they ask them panties, just keep on running. Don't give up, just keep on running. Because the Lord is there waiting for you. Because he's the finisher of the race. He set the trail. No devil didn't set the trail. No man can set the trail. Jesus made the trail out. He set the path. He put your enemies here. Because he know one day you're going to make them your footstools. He put trouble here. He put sickness here. Because he know you're going to overcome one day. For he overcame the world that we may have a chance to overcome the world. So thank God for Jesus Christ, the author and finisher of our race. So keep on running to Jesus. Keep on running to Jesus. And you'll see at the end, everything is going to be all right.